everyone. Welcome to week 5 of virtual Summer in the Garden, beginning botanist. I'm Miss Nicole, and this week's theme is pollinators versus pests. So I'm here in the nursery of the garden because this week we're talking all about the good and the bad bugs. So a great way to figure out what's happening in your garden with good and bad bugs is to scout. Scouting is simply just a way to survey and monitor and inspect your plants to look for signs and symptoms of disease or insects in your garden and your plants. And it's important to keep track of all of this stuff because if you have unhealthy plants, especially immature plants like the ones we have here in the nursery, then it could really affect our ecosystem, the animals around it, and of course, your plants aren't going to survive. 85% of plant diseases are actually caused by fungi. So, first, let's talk about good versus bad bugs. So, pollinators versus pests. Pollinators are obviously good bugs. They help our ecosystem. So some different good pollinators we have are like butterflies and bees. Some other good insects we have are ladybugs because they help control the population of the bad bugs or the pests, and spiders as well. Bad bugs destroy plants and organism activity. And then we also want to look for signs and symptoms of different infestations. So symptoms show diseases and signs show insect infestations. So I'm gonna go around this nursery and give you a few examples of things that you should look out for in your garden at home. And a good way to do this is to divide your garden into sections, and that way you can keep track of what section the infestation or the pest is happening. So here in the nursery, our nursery has different rows. So when Mary, our nursery manager, goes around and scouts, she writes down what row the infestation's happening in, what type of infestation, and what a good treatment plan is. So we'll go over all of that today. So you wanna be looking at different parts of the plants. You wanna look at the top of the leaves, the underside of leaves. You also wanna look at the stems and different things, things that kind of look out of the norm. Maybe something's been eaten, or a leaf has been curled up, the color of the leaf has changed, or maybe the pattern within the leaf veins has changed as well. So you can scout at least once a week is a good idea, and it's great to have a clipboard and a pen with you so you can keep track. If you have a large garden, it's good to keep track on where those infestations are happening. So let's take a look at a few examples. So here we have scarlet milkweed in the nursery. And we can see that here we've got some poor looking growth and rolled leaves, which could be a symptom of an insect infestation. So let's see, typically with milkweed, aphids are an issue. And if we look close right here, we can see those little yellow bugs. Those are aphids. So aphids will take over the plant and almost destroy it. And sometimes when you have aphids, there's also often ladybugs. So here I actually see a monarch caterpillar. And here is a ladybug. And the reason you see ladybugs is because their offspring will actually feed on the residue that the aphids leave. If you want to learn more about aphids, we actually have a species spotlight on them on our Google Classroom that you can check out. Right here we have some coontis, which are a native species that are actually endemic to South Florida. If you want to learn more about these species, you can check out our Google Classroom. There's also a species spotlight on these. And if we look close, we can see that these have scale, which is an insect infestation, and these are one of the bad guys. They will quickly take over and destroy a plant. A good way to get rid of these is just to hand pick them and remove them yourself. Here is some corky stem, which grows like a vine right across this fence here in the nursery. And we can see that some of this corky stem actually has some leaf miners. And you can tell because of this roadmap looking system here in the leaves, and that's actually an insect infestation that got in there and created that, and that can really damage the whole plant and the leaves. So it's good to care for that. If you want to learn more about corky stem, there's also a species spotlight on this as well. I'm in the outer end of our nursery looking at a white indigo berry tree. It's because we can see a very obvious spider mite infestation. And spider mites are little tiny spiders that create this webbing and they curl up the leaves and they can quickly take over an entire plant. So it's good to cut these off and dispose properly of the cuttings of the infected areas. Now that we looked at a few different examples, we need to identify if it's an insect or a disease issue. And once we figure out the issue, we can figure out the proper treatment. Hand picking and organic treatments are always the first options. It's much better than using pesticides or something that could harm the ecosystem, your plants, and the rest of the environment. So first, we can try to hand pick off the leaves or the insect that's there and bothering the plant. And once you hand pick these items off, you want to make sure that you throw them away. Do not put it in your compost. And you can also use different treatments such as insecticidal soaps, horticultural oil, neem oil, sulfur. So I have a great guide on our Google Classroom, our virtual living lab, that you can use, and it also has a scouting survey. So this guide will help you figure out good versus bad bugs, the diseases that plants can have, and the signs and symptoms, the scouting survey that you can use at your own garden at home that we use here in the nursery, and then you can figure out treatment plans. And it's important to treat your plants before your diseases or insect infestation spreads too much. So stay tuned for the rest of this week to figure out more about our pollinators and our pests.